Mr. Speaker, I recognize that today's debate is going to necessarily involve a variety of perspectives on what's the best policy for how we carry firearms on the streets of our Commonwealth. Now, some colleagues may feel that how we regulate firearms in Pennsylvania is appropriate and proper, and others may feel that we don't go far enough in our laws. I can understand and appreciate both of those perspectives. Where the difficulty lies for me, Mr. Speaker, in this debate is understanding the argument that somehow, as mass shootings have become regular occurrences and gun violence has escalated, that somehow, some way, what Pennsylvania needs right now is to remove the requirement for a license to carry a concealed firearm. Mr. Speaker, that principle just doesn't make any sense to me. I believe it is a good thing, a sensible policy, that before I acquire a license to carry a concealed firearm, I have to apply for that license with my local sheriff's office. I believe it is a good thing that before granting me that license, the sheriff's office conducts an investigation. I think it's sensible that that investigation considers things like my criminal record. And that's important. The sheriff's office investigation is important because not every firearm that is carried in Pennsylvania is purchased in Pennsylvania. So not everyone will be subject to our background check system. Pennsylvania has a distinct and robust background check system that we should be duly proud of. The sheriff's investigation process ensures that investigation takes place. It's also appropriate to consider things like mental health records and whether I might act in a manner that's dangerous to public safety. A sheriff's investigation considers all of that. Do I think we should eliminate a background check requirement for concealed carry? No. I think background checks are reasonable. So do most Pennsylvanians. Do I think Pennsylvania should be powerless to consider my mental health history? Should Pennsylvania ignore whether I am a potential threat to public safety? Should we turn a blind eye, Mr. Speaker, to any potential danger? Should we just throw our hands in the air and abdicate our governmental responsibility to balance individual liberties with the protection of the larger community? Mr. Speaker, I do not think that's sensible policy. I don't think the majority of Pennsylvanians want us to go down that road, and we shouldn't. Now, there's been some talk of constitutional rights in the debate surrounding this bill, and undoubtedly, constitutional rights are implicated. The Second Amendment of the Constitution, the Federal Constitution, and Article 1, Section 21 of our state constitution undoubtedly confer an individual right to bear arms for the purpose of self-defense. Both the United States Supreme Court and the Pennsylvania Supreme Court have been clear on that point. But where the courts have also been clear is that individual liberties, individual rights conferred by the Constitution do not exist in a vacuum. None of them do. The First Amendment, for example, states that Congress shall make no law abridging the freedom of speech. But we all understand and accept that that right doesn't mean you can say whatever you want, whenever you want. We can't, for example, threaten someone's life or publish certain obscene materials, even though both of those acts are considered speech. We can't do those things without some sort of penalty because we, as a society, as a country and a state of laws, recognize that in some instances, the community good takes precedence over an individual liberty. That same balancing of individual liberties and common good occurs with other constitutional rights. Whether it's a question of a warrantless search or the proper amount of bail or a law that regulates the sale, possession, or use of firearms, no right exists in a vacuum. And Pennsylvania courts have long recognized this basic legal idea. In 2009, our Commonwealth Court stated, quote, although the right to bear arms is a constitutional right, it is not unlimited, and restrictions are a proper exercise of police power if they are intended to protect society, end quote. The Pennsylvania Supreme Court also agrees. In a 2003 case, the Pennsylvania Supreme Court ruled, while the right to bear arms enjoys constitutional protection, like many other constitutional rights, it is not beyond regulation. My colleague, the gentlelady from Allegheny County, referenced Supreme Court Justice Antonin Scalia, who authored that landmark Heller decision. That decision, by the way, that recognized for the first time your right to own a firearm in your home for self-defense. Even Justice Scalia agreed with the principle that the right to bear arms is subject to regulation. I'll quote a different part of his Heller opinion, in which he says, nothing in our opinion should be taken to cast doubt on longstanding prohibitions on the possession of firearms by felons and the mentally ill, or laws forbidding the carrying of firearms in sensitive places, such as schools and government buildings, or laws imposing conditions and qualifications on the commercial sale of arms. So, Mr. Speaker, as we debate this bill, let's be honest in our terms. There is no legal support for the argument that the Second Amendment, or Section 21, means that no law can be passed regulating firearms. That's just not true. Further, there is no constitutional right to carry a concealed firearm without a license. There just isn't. There never has been. The constitutionality of concealed carry licenses has been challenged over and over and over again throughout the country and across the decades, and they have never been struck down, certainly not in Pennsylvania and not by any federal court. This bill purports to declare a constitutional right to permitless carry, but this legislative body knows full well that's not how it works. Constitutional rights are created, conferred, and expressed in the Constitution itself, not by some long-winded prefatory clause to an ordinary statute. So to anyone watching this at home or reading these remarks later, please understand that this bill, if it becomes law, doesn't create a constitutional right, and anyone who tells you otherwise is wrong. This legislative body knows all too well how to amend the Constitution. If you want to enshrine a protection in the Constitution, you have to let the people decide. My final concern with this bill, Mr. Speaker, is the matter of the age threshold. Right now, you must be age 21 to obtain a concealed carry permit. Now, personally, I do not think that children should be permitted to carry concealed firearms into their neighborhood park. Under this bill, that could happen. What this bill does is make it legal for children, an 8-year-old, for example, to engage in concealed carry so long as a parent is with them and approves of it. I'll explain. First, this bill does away with the age 21 requirement. Second, in this new section, 6106.2a, this bill purports to confer the right to, quote, every person in this Commonwealth to keep and bear firearms, including the right to carry openly or concealed. Now, you take that with existing law, Title 18, Section 6110.1, which currently allows for a minor to possess or transport a firearm if that minor is accompanied by their parent and the minor is engaged in lawful activity. What this bill does is make the very act of carrying lawful activity. That means that unless there's a specific statute barring guns in a particular place like a school, there is nothing stopping an 8-year-old from bringing a gun to a public place if mom or dad thinks it's okay. And so, at the next play date, at the local park, at the next 4th of July parade, or at the next Sunday service that I bring my kids to, I will be forced to entertain the possibility that my son's classmate or my daughter's friend may have brought a gun along. That's madness. Mr. Speaker, this is an ill-conceived bill, it is bad policy, and it misstates constitutional law. It will put lives in danger. I fear for my children and all of yours if this bill becomes law. History will judge this vote long after your primary is over. Do the right thing.